Hi guys, I'm making a new video about me talking about African holistic health. And from my previous video, I made a review about this book, right? And it's a really good book, and I did recommend you guys to get it. But also, there's a new addition to it, and it's much thicker. And you know, it still talks about the same thing, but there's more information added on to this book. Again, it's Dr. Laela Africa, and he again is a great influencer on Black people and talking about our, you know, about African, you know, holistic health. Pretty much, he's a great role model to me, in my opinion. He's such a great role model to me, and you know, I just feel like it is good to talk about him, and it's good to shine the light on him, and you know, to get more people to recognize him, and just to go over what he talks about, like the topics that he talks about in this book is disease remedies using herbs, vitamins, minerals, amnios, glandulards, recipes using natural foods, self-diagnosis charts, sexual personality types, food history, dangers of white sugar, and junk food. So these are the type of topics he brings up in the book, and there's more too that he brings up too. And what I personally like and what benefited me was he talked about hair products, and you know, some of the hair products that we buy are, you know, not really to say natural, and the chemicals that is used in it goes against, you know, our hair and what we put in our hair. And he gives good solutions into buying, you know, organic stuff, you know, organic things, you know, to help the hair grow in its natural way, instead of using these sorts of products to help damage it. Because usually when you buy, and he also mentioned in the book, it's like when you buy the product, it could also lie and fool you and say that, you know, it's natural, but you have to read the ingredients. And when you read the ingredients and what they put in it, and once you look it up and you know it's not like good for your hair, and it's going against it, you know, the growth, and you know, it's not really like aiming towards a healthy hair like growth, then you know, you shouldn't get it. And he labels all of those bad ingredients that they put in the products that you shouldn't really be getting. And that's what I love, because it's like a little dictionary that he you know, has, that where you can read and you could know which ones that are labeled. So when you look in the back, you can read the ingredients and you could see that you know, if it's on there, and if it's like, if it's mentioned in this book, and if it's not good for your hair, you know not to get it. Furthermore, just to say what I really wanted to talk about in this video is about marijuana, and he talks about it in this book too. And I want to talk, just give a little bit of my personal experience of it, and you know, the people who I used to be around with that, you know, went through it. So I've tried to memorize a page number, and it's 465, and it's called Smoking and Children. And why it talks about that, I'm gonna mention, you know, my personal experience is, like, you know, kids these days, and what I've seen, and with who I used to, you know, really surround myself with, they weren't really the best role models. They weren't really, you know, the best to say where they can help me grow, because, you know, they were going through a time, and they probably still are, which is, I don't, you know, put myself in that situation. It's just, they're still going through that trench, that stage, I should say. They're just still doing what, you know, they're not supposed to be doing, like smoking and you know, just getting high all the time. And I always used to just think, you know, like, what's the use of this? You know, what's so good about this? What's so, you know, cool about this when you know it's hurting you on the inside and, you know, everything? And I did try it once, and personally it did not work in my favor, and I honestly I'm glad that I did not continue into doing it, because I remember I tried, and when I tried it, it was horrible. My body had a bad reaction to it, and it wasn't good, you know. So yeah, and they say that once you keep doing it, you know, you'll get used to it, but I feel you just keep abusing your body even more when you keep doing it, you know. So it's best that you know, like, you just stop right there when you have a chance to just stop and don't go back, because, you know, if you keep doing it, of course you'll become addicted to it, and that's not what you want, unless, you know, everybody has their different, you know, their different values and their different priorities and stuff like that. And, you know, it's just sad to say sometimes, you know, the things that we do, it could hurt us. And, you know, I know I'm not perfect myself, because, you know, I've been through some things that I totally regret, but it's good to have something that could guide you. Even if you don't have, and, you know, someone to guide you, at least you can read about something that could guide you, and this is the book for it. So moving forward into what I'm gonna read, I'm just gonna read a little bit of what, you know, this topic says. And it says here, is cooked oil droplets in smoked tobacco, marijuana, a natural food for the body? No, it is not. The lungs were not designed for the inhalation of smoke. Lungs are anatomically structured to inhale clean air, not polluted air. You know, so pretty much, you know, he's saying, you know, like, again, you know, your body is structured for you to help you, you know, not to go against you, and, you know, to put this stuff in your body. Your body was not designed for it, you know. So when he said, you know, you're supposed to breathe in clean air, not polluted air, you know, he's talking about the smoke, like smoking and stuff. The cancer-causing and mood-altering drugs are in the oil droplet form in the smoke. The burning of tobacco and or marijuana creates a drug. Fire heat added to leaves, tobacco, marijuana makes a synthetic poisonous chemical, a trans oil synthetic drug. So just to, like, say, once, like, the thing is, it's a plant. Weed is a plant, right? And once you burn it down to that single point, it turns into a drug, you know. So you get rid of all the nutrients, you get rid of all, you know, the good things, that elements that belongs in the plant, and you burn that all off, and it releases it, and, you know, you just create one single thing that in a drug form. So it's pretty much like when, like, let's just say, like, a whole chicken, and then you kill the chicken and you process the chicken, you know, they process the chicken into where, you know, they try to make it into that one thing where, you know, it tastes good and everything. They add on these things to make it taste good. And, you know, this is why he mentions also junk foods and that sort of stuff, you know. So what I meant with the chicken is, like, you know, you make it reach that point, and it's like an unhealthy food that, you know, it's obvious it's not good to eat. But I try to, like, you know, make it similar to, like, you know, what he meant by smoking and, like, you know, it becoming like a synthetic drug. It damages your hormone imbalance, decreases oxygen to the child's brain, and cancer. An adult who smokes in the presence of a child causes the child to inhale the oil droplet drug and smoke. This forced passive smoking is child abuse, a crime, and is destructive to the child's health. So yes, parents, you know, they should be a good influence on kids. They should be a good role model. And to have these sort of things where you're smoking in front of them and where you're, like, you know, being high all the time and not giving them the attention that they need, I guess, is, like, neglectful and it's abuse, pretty much, you know. And he just goes on furthermore saying, you know, the high or medical benefit was, oh yeah, he just goes on saying, let me go back. He says the drugs and smoke weaken the lungs, liver, kidneys, skin, immunity, and destroy vitamin C. The cannabinol THC drug in marijuana used to make people feel high. So it's a THC that's in the marijuana. It's like the thing that's in the marijuana to make, you know, the person feel high. Sorry, I'm just like, I'm just a little bit tired. I'm just making this so late, this video so late at night, but I'm gonna get through this video. And as he was saying again, one marijuana cigarette is equal to the damage that smoking 10 tobacco cigarettes at one time. The high or medical benefit with 2%, 1950, and currently is 15 to 20% higher in a marijuana cigarette. This makes marijuana addicting with no research on the higher destruction. The smoke from one marijuana cigarette destroys the vitamin C content of 12 oranges. So what he's saying is, like, you know, when it comes to oranges and stuff, and just smoking one cigarette, just smoking one marijuana cigarette is equal to, like, damaging 12 oranges. And, like, you know, the vitamin C that's in the orange, it's destroying that just by smoking one marijuana cigarette. And it's pretty sad, because if it could do that, then, you know, just imagine, you know, putting this in your body. It's already damaging all the vitamins that you could have possibly in your body, and the more you keep smoking it, the more it's damaging, and your body is trying its best to repair itself, you know, just in order for it to function at its best, you know. The chemicals in smoke can cause skipped heartbeats, palpitation of the heart, nervousness, rapid heart rates, paralysis of the cilia hair in the lungs, dizziness, shortness of breath, headaches from rises in blood pressure, and pains of distress over the front of the chest. Smoke decreases circulation to the hands, feet, legs. The nicotine in tobacco causes the veins to constrict, close. It closes the veins, and this limits the blood flow to the heart, sex organs, and other vital organs. So, you know, when they said, like, you know, when this erectile dysfunction, so, like, you know, let's just say when, you know, you're about to have sex and everything, you're having erectile dysfunction, and if you know you smoke a lot, that's due to you having erectile dysfunction, because smoking can cause, and again, it says here, it stops the frequent flow of the blood going through your body that's meant to be, and it shortens it, and it just closes up the veins, as he says here. The female passive smoker undergoes menopause at a younger age. So let's just say a female is smoking, she's going to go through menopause at a younger age, and, you know, it's going to make it a higher risk for her and everything. Children learn by example. As I was saying, you know, children we learn, and personally, I'm a teen, so, like, you know, having a parent, you know, as your role model is a really important role. And he's saying, you know, like, children learn from the parents, obviously, and to see that, you know, a parent is acting in this manner and is doing this is unsafe, obviously, it's very unsafe. And, you know, he says, furthermore, historically, the original smoke eaters, nicotine drug addicts, were Caucasians. Blacks who are nicotine drug smokers are socially conditioned, engineered, seasoned to do so. So this has to go back a little bit in history. You know, he's saying that, you know, I'm not really trying to offend any of, you know, the viewers, but this is what is mentioned, because I'm saying this is a black-based book, like, it's aimed towards black people and bettering themselves, so this book is not really for Caucasians. And he's saying, you know, that, you know, they were the original ones who were doing this stuff, and we're the ones who were influenced, and when he said, socially engineered, like, conditioned into doing this, is where, like, we now picked up this practice and we're doing this, and, you know, the original ones were Caucasian. Just to end it off right there, I love this book, and it's such a good book, and honestly, the things that he says could be just earning to other people, it could be amazing, could be inspirational, but honestly, he just speaks the truth. And if you really want to get this book, you should get it. You know, it helps you with, you know, your health, obviously. It helps you make you a better person, and I know it's helping me. So, again, you know, whoever sees this video, I thank you for watching this. I thank you for, at least if you learned something from this video, I'll be so grateful that you learned something. And please comment on what you think and what you learned, you know, whatever you want to say, just comment it. And yes, this is the new edition of African Holistic Health. This is the old edition. This is the old one, but this is the new one. And yes, all I can say is I hope you guys have a good night, day, afternoon, whatever. And, you know, I hope you guys really enjoy this video, and, you know, please tell me whatever you think.